500,000. Half a million. Halfway to a million. No matter how many times I repeat it to myself, I can't believe so many people have subscribed to my non-mainstream channel. Thank you very much to each and every one of you. Thank you for giving me a place here on YouTube. I want to celebrate this massive milestone by doing a little experiment for every hazard in my hazard roulette. I've never used them all in a single video, until now. Let's start with magnetism, the backbone of my channel. This will be a challenge for you to think about. I want you to have a guess at how many of the following objects can be lifted by a magnet. An incandescent light bulb, an LED bulb, a soda can, a glass bead, and an iron supplement, also known as an iron pill. How many of these five can be lifted by this magnet? I haven't given you much info, so consider it carefully and I'll give you the answer later in the video. For radioactivity, I would like to follow up on my latest video where I showed the weak magnetism of thorium in my series Exotic Elements vs. Magnets. In an earlier part I showed uranium near a magnet, but I have never managed to show the paramagnetism of uranium. I wanna fix that, but first let's just confirm it is still radioactive. Of course it is. The half-life of uranium-238 is 4.5 billion years, so the sun will burn out before this stops being radioactive. Time to test its magnetism on a sensitive water bath. There's a lot of glass compared to the 500 milligrams of uranium, so this will not be easy. The first result is a failure. The sample is repelled by the magnet. This is the diamagnetism of the glass, not the attractive paramagnetism of uranium I'm looking for. I need to get closer to the uranium and use a magnet with a farther reaching magnetic field. There we have it. Uranium is attracted to a magnet. So now you know and have even seen it too. I will have to revisit the lanthanides too, so part 7 is on my long to-do list of videos. Moving on to high voltage, which is an area I haven't touched in my videos yet. But it certainly will happen in the future, because there are some truly interesting topics to cover here. For now, you will have to do with these proof of concept shots. I'm playing with electrons using a plasma ball as a safe high voltage source. I will make a video where I look into the science of this beautiful display. Make sure you have clicked the notification bell if you would like to see the video. My videos easily drown in your other subscriptions. Blood is the only biohazard I have featured in a video. It was in the popular Monster Magnet Meets Blood. I want to follow up on that by letting a magnet touch the blood directly to see if anything in it sticks to a magnet. If you are sensitive to blood, close your eyes now and just listen. Alright, the blood is out again. Let's put a magnet in it and see if anything from the blood collects on the pole of the magnet. Nice color, but I don't see anything sticking to the pole of the magnet. I tried to explain why in the original video. There are super paramagnetic molecules in our bodies that could stick to a magnet, like ferritin and hemosiderin. They luckily just aren't freely floating around in our blood. Still no reasons to worry about being near a magnet, despite our iron content. I wonder about that iron pill. In my video Burn It, Ferro Fluid vs. Fairy Paste, I set fire to both over a magnet. But I didn't move the magnet. What will happen if I move the magnet while they are on fire? Only one way to find out. I'm starting with ferrofluid. There we go. Time to move the magnet. Not much different than with a steady magnet. Or so I thought. Don't copy my mistakes, just learn from them. What you see is a thermal shock in the glass. By stirring the fluid with the magnet, it burns faster than with the steady magnet. Faster burn equals faster rise in temperature, so the glass didn't have time to spread the heat. The center expanded much faster from the heat than the outer part. The glass couldn't handle the stress and decided to split. Will it be the same with fairy paste? This did better. It is a paste and isn't stirred in the same way. It just wiggles and didn't heat the glass as fast. But as always, don't let fire play with you. Ah, lasers. One of my favorite topics. I love the laser tunnel effect. It looks awesome and is not difficult or expensive to pull off. I need to make a video about it. For now, just enjoy my test shots. Time to test which can be lifted by the magnet. The incandescent bulb is attracted to the magnet, but not enough to be lifted. The other one is easily picked up by the magnet. The main difference seems to be the metal base, where the incandescence is made of aluminium and the LEDs of some cheaper steel. And speaking of aluminium and steel, the soda can is magnetic. This contains iron since it is made of tin-plated steel, not an aluminium alloy like the more common alu can. The top though is made of aluminium. How about the glass bead? Glass is usually repelled by a magnet as shown in the uranium test. But this one is different. It can be lifted by a magnet since it is doped with gadolinium. It's so odd seeing glass sticking to a magnet. The iron pill is not lifted. Like with the iron in our blood, there's no pure elemental iron in it. It contains a tiny amount of ferrous fumarate, which is magnetic enough for the pill to follow the magnet, but not enough to be lifted. So three of them could be lifted. Did you guess right? Thanks to all my patrons. I'm so happy you are willing to support me on patreon.com. And a special thanks to Tony Walls for going way beyond highest tier. It's very generous of you. Thank you, Tony. Alright, hope you enjoyed this celebration video with references to previous and future videos. And thank you once again for subscribing. Remember to click like if you saw something you liked in the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.